Have you ever been curious about the way airplane engines are tested?
Yes.
What you just witnessed was the unusual sight of a chicken being propelled into an aircraft engine. Now, I know it sounds bizarre, but there's a method to the madness. But why are these tests important? Airplane engines undergo rigorous trials to ensure safety and reliability, examining every aspect to withstand challenges and ensure their ability to perform effectively. One such test involves releasing high-pressure water, while another involves firing dead birds directly into the engine. Dead birds into the engine? All right. I understand that it's quite shocking. We won't keep you in suspense any longer. So without any further ado, let's dive straight into the theory behind these wild trials. First, let's take a look at the bird strike testing. The Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, reveals that a whopping 10,000 bird strikes occur each year. That's more than 26 feathered encounters every single day. And the damage? Hold on to your feathers, because it totals a staggering $1.2 billion annually. Remember the unforgettable Miracle on the Hudson? That's right, a flock of birds turned that heroic flight into a life or death situation when they destroyed both engines. What you're seeing right now is the extent of the damage caused by a bird hit. Manufacturers use tests like the chicken gun, a cannon that launches chicken carcasses to ensure engine safety, mimicking bird strikes. While most engines handle it like a breeze, larger strikes can cause engine shutdowns. Thankfully, due to exceptional engineering, fatalities are rare. Well, for humans at least. For our feathered friends, it's a different story. Before we continue, hit that like button and subscribe to our channel today. Aircraft engines face extreme weather conditions such as rain and storms, requiring proper function to handle large amounts of water. Manufacturers subject them to intense water ingestion tests, consuming up to 800 gallons of water per minute forcefully fed into running engines. The goal is to determine if the engine can gulp it down without losing thrust. Even engines undergo wind tests to combat crosswinds, causing turbulence and disrupting the aircraft's course. High-speed air blasting and simulated crosswinds forcefully sweep across the engine to prevent mishaps. Well, these tests are nothing compared to the intense trials of fire and ice. Cold temperatures pose challenges for engines, requiring testing. One way is to place an engine in a cold environment for days or weeks. The other is to shoot ice into a running engine, mimicking a hailstorm. But the heat is no joke either. Engines also face extreme heat and extended periods of maximum temperatures, similar to ice-like issues. Now, aircraft engines undergo the altitude or vacuum chamber test to simulate high altitude conditions. This test evaluates their ability to handle pressure, thrive in thin air, and withstand potential failures. Can the engine handle the pressure? Well, if everything goes smoothly, the engine is ready for the next test. Thrust reversal testing is crucial for safe landings, as engine slowness is essential for landing safely. No room for disaster here. So, each engine undergoes the ultimate test of thrust reversal. This test is conducted in a full-scale wind tunnel, like the one you see on the screen, where the aircraft is simulated while the thrust reversers are engaged. But that's not all. The test also uncovers the hidden danger of fuel vapors lurking in the air intakes. Modern aircraft engines still undergo reverse thrust tests for reliable operations and safe landings. Over the past two decades, engine manufacturers have worked to silence these decibel demons. And boy, have they succeeded. They've been working tirelessly to make engines as hush-hush as possible, aiming for a whopping 65% reduction in noise levels by 2050. These engines can produce 140 decibels at full power, but when operating outdoors, they maintain noise levels at 60 decibels, meeting environmental requirements and reducing discomfort for humans. But how do they measure and control the noise? Well, it's all about precision and compliance. As you can see, the engine's sound levels are meticulously measured by placing them outside, where super-sensitive microphones are ready to capture even the slightest fluctuations, from low power to maximum thrust. Every decibel is accounted for. And lastly, an aircraft engine undergoes flight OT sky tests to ensure reliability. After passing ground tests, it's taken to the sky to test its performance using modified aircraft known as test beds. Examples? GE's Boeing 747-700 flying test bed. These beds test the engine's capabilities in various situations, including high altitudes and maximum speed. After passing these tests, the engine is certified safe and reliable for use on an actual aircraft. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, and don't miss any of our upcoming interesting topics. So what do you think about these tests? Leave your thoughts in the comments below.